Al, thank you very much. After a two-year hiatus, singing superstar Celine Dion is back with a new baby and a new record titled A New Day Has Come, and also a new outlook on life. But now Celine must overcome a new challenge. Her husband, Renee Angelil, has facing civil charges on sexual battery, charges that Renee told me over the weekend are completely unfounded. As a matter of fact, he said he will come on this program and talk about those charges when he is allowed to. But recently, I sat down with Celine to talk about her career and her feelings about motherhood.
I love being a mother, and it makes me like I make a difference in somebody's life. And
someone needs you so much.
I know, and also that the priorities are changing a lot, even more towards family. I was family-oriented before. You can just imagine now.
Is motherhood what you expected it would be?
Even better.
I read something in an article, and I know you weren't being honest, okay? So I want to catch you in a lie right now. You said you actually like even changing the diapers, that
but
you
I
love
do.
It.
Oh, I
can't love changing diapers.
I love it because I can talk to him like this and say, Mommy's going to change the diaper. Ooh, what's that? I make faces. He's having a good time. And
see, I'm a member.
I want to be very careful because when I change that, I think, I'm sorry, I just opened a parenthesis here. But when you open the diaper, this is the truth in there. You gotta look carefully. Whatever they eat, you want to know if they digest it well? If they're well hydrated? Oh, yeah, it's like a Bible.
So
you gotta look in
on,
there, yeah.
When I go into Jack, I should say, come on, Jack, tell Daddy the truth, and then that's what it's gonna mean?
He doesn't even have to talk.
You went back in the studio 6 months after having Renee Charles.
Mm-hmm.
First of all, how is Renee doing, your husband and father? Because he had a health scare.
Yes.
And this baby is kind of the second of two blessings. The first was Renee's health improving, and the second is the baby. Yeah. How's Renee doing now?
Well, I'm knocking on wood. The other man of my life is doing so far so good. He's doing great, and it's almost 3 years, and we have to be patient and wait 5 years in remission. But so far so good. We take a day at a time, and my son is helping father to go on every day more than ever. And what touched me is when he took his son for the first time in his arms and he said, I almost lost my life and now I'm giving life. And they're the two men of my life, and they're both doing, they keep me busy.
Yeah.
And it's incredible, and they love each other, and it's touching for me to see that.
When you went back in the studio after having a baby, was it hard to get, you'd been not recording and performing for a while.
Mm-hmm.
How long was it?
Well, it was at least two years.
Even more than that,
because my last album was like a while ago. But it was scary, let's put it that way.
But was it hard to get your voice back in shape?
Yes, because my teacher told me, Celine, you can't stop training. You're going to take your 2 years off, but please continue talking and performing and vocalizing. And I didn't listen to him. I unplugged. I didn't do anything. I sang while I was pregnant in my shower for my pleasure, but I didn't train.
What's training? What do you have to do? I mean,
well,
what is your version of training?
Things like this. You do like 15 minutes a day. Not only this, things that sounds even worse than that. But it's just a stretching of the vocals, the muscles. Instead of stretching your body, stretching your vocal cords. And when I started to sing, just an easier song. And it went well, and I couldn't wait to go back in the recording studio, and I loved the songs that people wrote for me on this album. And those songs became even closer to me because the fact that I took 2 years off, they wrote songs to me that was even closer to my emotions. I had things to talk about. I had things to sing about. And it was a fun adventure, no pressure, relaxed, smooth, powerful but controlled. I really had a wonderful time, and to see my friends again, and it was great.
I think of, when I hear your name, I think of great ballads, of course. I think most people do. Are there some great ballads on this record?
Oh, there is great ballads on this record. I was fortunate again. If I think of one song, Have You Ever Been in Love, which is an incredible ballad, but also the title of the album, which is like A New Day Has Come. And this song, of course, captures. Another song could have not captured better the emotion and what we've been through. And not only Renee and me and my son, but what the world's been through recently. always sing those ballads because this is part of me and this is what I love to do. And
I just read that you signed a mega deal in Las Vegas. This is a big deal. From what I understand, you'll be at Caesar's Palace 5 nights a week, 40 weeks a year.
Yeah. It's going to be 200 shows a year.
Why did you want to jump into such a, and that's a big commitment.
Well, 2 years ago, it is. 2 years ago, I saw the Cirque du Soleil, the show O, with Franck Dragon. It changed my perspective of seeing performances. And I said to Renee, I want a show like that. He said, Celine, you can't travel with a show like this. You can't travel the world. It's technically impossible. But I said, let's move.
See, it's interesting to me to hear that it was the show that prompted it. I thought maybe it was the baby that prompted it because you didn't want to jump on the road as much anymore. You wanted more to stick some roots down.
Well, yeah, don't get me wrong. Like, of course, a lot of people are saying that. I wasn't even pregnant when I made up my mind. But it makes it even, my mind is even clearer about it now. First, because I'm going to be able to be excited about going every night and do a show that I'm going to look forward to do. Visual show. Every song will be like an adventure, like an experience. But of course, I mean, it's not like a detail. It's going to be a big thing that my son will be home every night also, and I won't have to worry. So, of course, it's a big plus.
Do you do anything halfway? I mean, and I'm being honest about this. Do you do anything and kind of just skim over the details, or do you do everything where you just dive into it?
Well, I do everything that I can just dive into it, and I can dive for one reason, because I love what I'm doing, and the second of all, because I can trust my team. I know if I jump, they're going to put water in the pool, and I can count on them.
It is 7:41. Still to come this morning, we'll introduce you to